Today we will discuss conservation of momentum, and in conservation of momentum we will discuss direct collision. Now in direct collision we are taking a special case when two balls A and B are moving along a straight line with initial velocities u1 and u2 respectively. u1 is greater than u2. Find the velocities of the balls immediately after the collision given कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ रेस्टिट्यूशन इज ई. दिस इज व्हाट वी इंटेंड टू फाइंड. हमें निकालना है कि कोलिजन के बाद ये दोनों बॉल्स की वेलोसिटी क्या है. इन दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक वी विल डिस्कस फर्स्ट इज एप्लीकेशन ऑफ इंपल्स मोमेंटम थ्योरम एंड सेकेंड इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ कोलिजन दैट इज ई टाइम्स वेलोसिटी ऑफ अप्रोच इज इक्वल टू वेलोसिटी ऑफ separation. Now when these two bodies collide, this point will be the point of impact, this line will be the common tangent, and obviously this line will be the line of impact. So we know that impulse acts along line of impact. So let's give the name, the balls as the name. This ball is A, this is B, and obviously u1 is greater than u2 for the collision to take place. The mass of this ball A is m1, the mass of this ball B is m2, the velocities after collision are v1 and v2 of the two balls, and obviously v1 should be lesser than v2 for these two balls to separate. Now this is ball A, this is ball B. The impulse imparted to ball A by ball B is in this direction, and the impulse imparted to ball B by ball A is in this direction by Newton's third law. Every action has an equal and opposite reaction, right? So let's write the impulse as I, and here also it will be I. Now applying impulse momentum theorem for ball A, we get impulse I, this is in the negative x-axis, so it is minus I. This is equal to, what is the change in momentum of ball A? It is, the final momentum of ball A is m1 v1. This is along positive x-axis, minus the initial momentum of ball A is m1 u1. Now the impulse momentum theorem for ball B is, the impulse is acting along positive x-axis, so it is taken as positive I plus I. This is equal to, the final momentum of the ball is, ball B is m2 v2 minus m2 u2. Now on adding these two equations we have 0 is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2 minus m1 u1 plus m2 u2. Now as you can see that this particular equation or this particular term is the final momentum of the system. If the two balls are taken together as a system, then their momentum is conserved, because the net impulse acting on the two balls as a system is zero. So this is the final momentum minus this is the initial momentum of the system, right? So we can write minus pi. In vector notation we can write it as minus pi vector. So we get m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. Now this is the first equation which we have. This was the impulse acting on the two balls, the velocities of the balls v1 v2, and obviously the mass of the ball is m1 m2. Now what is velocity of approach? Since u2 is lesser than u1 and the velocity of approach is taken along the line of impact, so we have E times U1 minus U2 is equal to V2 minus V1. This is the second equation which we have. We want to solve these two equations for V1 and V2. Now how to solve it? Isko solve karne ke liye, multiply the second equation by M1 on either of the sides and add the two equations. We get it is M1 U1 1 plus E minus U2 or it is plus U2 M2 minus E M1 is equal to M1 plus M2 times V2. So we get V2 as M1 U1 1 plus E plus U2 M2 minus EM1 divided by M1 plus M2. So we get the velocity V2 as this value. Now how to find the value of V1? Now we need not have to worry about it. We need not have to solve the other equation as well. Simply what we do is we interchange the value of 1 and 2 in the subscript. हम 1 और 2 की value को subscript में interchange कर देते हैं. 2 की जगह 1 लिखते हैं और 1 की जगह 2 लिखेंगे. यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हो, it is m2 u2 1 plus e plus u1 m1 minus e m2 divided by m1 plus m2. तो ये रिजल्ट हमको हमेशा ध्यान रखना पड़ेगा कि इस तरीके से हम अगर सबस्क्रिप्ट में 1 और 2 की वैल्यू को इंटरचेंज करते हैं, देन वी कैन गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ V1 एंड V2 वेरी इजीली. सो लेट्स सॉल्व इट फॉर सम सिंपल केस हियर ओनली. सपोज आई टेक द वैल्यू ऑफ से ई एज 1. सपोज ई इज इक्वल टू 1. And there is a case, let's call this case as the first case. It is M1 is very small as compared to M2. U1 is equal to U and U2 is equal to 0. We want to find what is the value of V1. Now substitute the value of U2 here as 0. So this entire term becomes 0. Here it is M1 minus M2 because E is equal to 1, so it becomes minus M2 because M1 is very small as compared to M2. U1 is U divided by M1 plus M2 divided by M1 plus M2, so again it becomes M2 only. So we get the value of V1 as U minus M2 because M1 is very small as compared to M2 and the value of E is 1 divided by M2. So these two M2 cancels out and we get the value of V1 as minus U. The negative sign indicates that any object which is very light as compared to the object with which it is colliding and is at rest, it simply changes its direction. Yaad rakho ki agar ek bahut light object ek bahut heavy object ke saath jo ki rest pe hai usse collide karta hai, तो वो जिस वेलोसिटी से आएगा उसी वेलोसिटी से वापस चला जाएगा. इट विल रिटर्न विद द सेम वेलोसिटी, राइट. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस टू V2? लेट्स चेक इट आउट वेदर द हैवी ऑब्जेक्ट विल गेन सम वेलोसिटी और नॉट. सिंपली सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज ऑफ U2 इज अगेन 0. हियर वी गेट इट इज M1 U 1 प्लस 1 बिकम्स 2, सो इट इज 2 M1 U डिवाइडेड बाई M1 प्लस M2. So we have it is 2 M1 U divided by M1 plus M2. Now since M2 is very large as compared to M1, therefore we get 2 U into M1 upon M2, which is approximately equal to 0 for the given condition. So we get, in this case, we get the value of V2 as approximately 0. So this is how we can solve it for other values as well. I'll give you the other values. You need to work it out, you can solve it for E is equal to 1. The second case will be M1 is very large as compared to M2, U1 is U and U2 is 0. You can get the values of V1 as U and V2 as 2U. The third will be when M1 is equal to M2, the collision is perfectly elastic and with same velocities. Then we get V1 as 0 and V2 as U. Remember, the velocities, if the collision is head-on, or I'm writing it down, if the colliding bodies are equal in mass and collision is perfectly elastic, that is E is equal to 1, then they interchange their velocities along the line of impact just before and just after the collision. You can see in this case, it was the velocities of the colliding bodies before the collision was U1, which was U and 0. This was M1 is equal to M2. The masses are same. We are discussing the third case. After collision, their velocities along the line of impact interchange. V1 becomes 0 and V2 becomes U. So their velocities along the line of impact interchanges.